Hey, what's up, guys? It's Ronaldo here. So, there's now another racist incident with regards to the Springboks. Yeah, this is now the third incident in less than 48 hours that people are now trying to claim that there are some racist white Springbok players. Now, note that all of them are targeting white players, right? Firstly, so clearly there's a Stratcom working behind the scenes to destabilize the Springboks. I don't know why. Maybe people have put a lot of money on New Zealand winning this, and because South Africa is looking so good, they're trying to cause some havoc within the team. I don't know. But first we had Eben Etzebeth that is allegedly involved in a racist incident, and even now there's attempted murder charges by the South African Human Rights Commission. Then that kind of died down a little bit. And then Frans Steyn is now fingered in being racist with regards to the bomb squad refusing to hug Mapimpi. And once everything was explained and once Mapimpi came out and said everything and set the record straight, there are still people that are saying, no, you know, this is unacceptable. He was coerced into that statement, which is quite ironic because you are now acting more racist by saying that a black man can't speak for himself. Because if he does, then he is coerced or something untowards is happening there. That in itself, it's racist. I hope you understand that. But the most recent incident that is now trending on social media is Jesse Krill. And Jesse Krill is now being accused of not wanting to stand next to Mapimpi, and therefore he's a racist. Now, you can see what everybody's talking about in this video.
Look at this piece of racism taking place. Jesse Krill, they're calling the white boy to come stand next to him. He do not want to stand against the next boy. Look at him. Look at him calling the white boy. Now he pushed the black boy aside. Come. And look at that. Jesse Krill, still a racist. Now look at the black boy there. He didn't even want to put his hands around him.
Yeah, so Jesse Krill is a racist for not wanting to stand next to Mapimpi. Even though Elton Yankees is on his other side and he's also not white. You know, Elton Yankees is a colored individual and Jesse Krill standing next to him. No, let's ignore that. Let's focus on him pushing Mapimpi aside and wanting his center combination next to him. Because I'm not sure if you understand how rugby works, but when you line up to sing the national anthem, what usually should happen is you should stand in your position. So number 1 to number 15, and then the bomb squad or the reserves can stand however they want to. But that is usually how it is supposed to work. And here's an example of that. You see, that's not that hard, right? Number 1 to number 15, and then the bomb squad, which is 16 to 23, they usually screw it up. But usually it should be 1 to 23. That is how it's supposed to work. Now, this video in question with regards to Jesse Krill, if you look at the video, you can clearly see that firstly, he's asking Mapimpi to move to his right because Mapimpi is number 11. Krill is number 12. And then Esterhazen is number 13. That is the lineup that should have taken place. So when Jesse Krill told Mapimpi to come and he see that he didn't, then he just pulled Esterhazen next to him because that is how the lineup is supposed to work. What absolutely blows my mind is that we actually have to explain this. People want to find racism in the most outlandish places, and usually what you'll find is the people that are making these racist claims don't know the fucking first thing about rugby. A perfect example of this is Carl Newhouse. Now, he's the former spokesperson of the ANC. He came out and posted this tweet. Now, there are many examples of people posting that video and saying, but what about this? You know, and they don't know the first thing about rugby. Social media influencers, brand influencers coming out and posting this, and they don't know what exactly needs to happen. And like I said in my previous video, and I would like to reiterate right here, fuck you for wanting to cause racial divide in this country by spreading fake news. And that's basically all I've got to say. If you enjoy my content, then please consider becoming a member. You can do so by hitting the join button below. And this is where it differs now. So I hope you continued listening, because I would like you in the comments to say, fuck fake racism. That's what I would like you to comment in the comments below. Please be sure to subscribe, hit that bell icon. Please be sure to hit the like button. Please be sure to share this video with your friends and family, because that's literally the only way my message gets out there. Till later, cheers and peace out.